He's with me and he's been traveling to various cities doing sessions on cloud. So Michael, just wanted to check with you, when you're talking to most of the customers or CIOs, what do they feel that when they move towards the cloud services, whether flexibility and efficiency are some of their topmost concerns when they're looking at a service provider?
Yeah, it's actually it's quite interesting actually. Over the last 12 to 18 months or so, it's steadily shifted from a focus purely on cost savings, hardware cost savings primarily, a reduction or elimination in capital expenditures, towards a focus on really the real value and the value for driving innovation is around business flexibility. It's around let's say the freedom from owning technology. The ability to focus on services that that technology enables.
We've been talking to most of the customers, and when they talk about cloud services, they talk about security and privacy as one of the concerns. Can you elaborate what you listen from your customers when you talk to them?
Sure, absolutely. I think you're right. The two major concerns are security and data privacy, data residency. And I think there are certainly valid concerns, but the truth is a lot of the concerns are related to a lack of knowledge. Lack of understanding about cloud computing. And the reality is for most organizations, they are not security experts, whereas cloud providers, just by dint of their very role, have to be security experts. So ironically, what we expect to see over the next 12, 18, 24 months, as organizations increase their level of understanding of cloud, they will increase their level of comfort around things like security and data residency, data privacy, pretty dramatically.
Yeah, and I agree with you because that's our role as a technology provider to kind of educate them on secure multi-tenant architectures which are being deployed by these cloud service providers. So these are certain things I believe we need to do from our side.
Sure.
If I have to kind of go further, what do you talk about, how do you talk about the cloud services market per se in coming times, maybe a year or 18 months from now? What's your uptake? As an analyst?
Well, in terms of plans, both current adoption plans and longer term, meaning 6-12 month adoption plans, the acceleration has been quite pronounced. This is true within India, but across the region as well. So the percent of organizations that have active plans in place continues to increase. It's particularly true among large organizations. What we're seeing is the larger organization in general, the more educated they are about all the issues that go into cloud. Ironically, smaller organizations, particularly in a place like India, are in a far better position to benefit from cloud because they can essentially skip a whole generation of infrastructure investments. The problem is they don't yet have the education and the knowledge to take advantage of that, what we consider a leapfrog opportunity.
Okay. One last bit. From a cloud services perspective, how important is storage when you talk to the end customer as well as for the service provider, if you can give some insight.
Sure. When we talk to customers, one of the key points that we do, particularly when we do our primary research and ask organizations the types of workloads that they're looking to prioritize for potential leverage in a cloud-based environment. Storage is one of the key environments that they're looking at, particularly for private cloud initiatives. But it's one of the key workloads, and our recommendation is, in fact, to focus on those workloads, like storage, as a starting point. Cloud shouldn't be done for the sake of cloud. It should be done based on particular workloads, and storage is a absolutely logical potential first workload to consider.
Thanks a lot, Michael. It was nice talking.
You too.
Thank you.